Janet and Rabia.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
In this solved exercise, we are going to apply the principle of conservation of mechanical energy to determine the speed of a moving object. Determine the velocity of the center of mass of the two colliding objects. Calculate the speeds of two colliding objects right after the collision. And specify whether the collision is elastic.
An object A considered as a particle of mass 2 kg can slide without friction on a vertical track formed by two parts, a curved part Dn and a horizontal straight part Nm. Look at the figure. A is released without initial velocity from point D, situated at a height of 0.45 meters above Nm. The horizontal plane passing through Nm is taken as a reference level for gravitational potential energy. Take the gravitational acceleration as 10 meters per second squared, part 1. Calculate the mechanical energy of the system A Earth at point D. The mechanical energy at point D is given by this expression, the kinetic energy at point D plus the gravitational potential energy at point D. The object is released from rest, then the velocity at point D is equal to zero, therefore the kinetic energy at point D is equal to zero. Then we still have only the gravitational potential energy, which is given by this expression, MAGHD. The mass is 2 kilograms, the gravitational acceleration is 10 meters per second squared, and H is equal to 0.45 meters. Therefore, the mechanical energy at point D is equal to 9 joules. Part 2. Deduce the speed V1A of A when it reaches point N. We will use the conservation of mechanical energy. The object slides without friction, then the mechanical energy is conserved. Or we can say that the sum of the works done by the non-conservative forces is zero between D and N, then the mechanical energy is conserved. So we have the mechanical energy at point D is equal to the mechanical energy at point N. The mechanical energy at point N is given by kinetic energy at point N plus GPE at point N. But look at the figure. Point N is on the reference level for gravitational potential energy. Then GPE at point N is equal to zero. So we still have the kinetic energy at point N, which is given by this expression, 1/2 MA V1A squared. The mechanical energy at point D is equal to 9 joules, the mass is 2 kilograms, and V1A is unknown. Therefore, V1A is equal to 3 meters per second.
Part 3. A reaches N and moves along NM with the same velocity V1AI. Another object B, considered as a particle of mass MB equal 4 kilograms, moves along the horizontal path from M towards N with a velocity V1B equal minus I. V1B is expressed in meters per second. 3.1. Determine the linear momentum PS of the system AB before the collision. The linear momentum of the system AB is equal to the linear momentum of A plus that of B. The linear momentum of A is equal to MA times V1A, and that of B is equal to MB times V1B. Now, replace each physical quantity by its value. MA is equal to 2 kilograms, V1A is equal to 3i, MB is equal to 4 kilograms, and V1B is equal to minus I. Therefore, PS is equal to 2i, expressed in kilograms meters per second. 3.2. Deduce the velocity VG of the system AB. We know that the linear momentum of the center of mass of the system is given by the total mass of the system times the velocity of the center of mass of the system. Now, replace MA by 2 kg, MB by 4 kg. Therefore, PG is equal to 6 times VG. But the linear momentum of the system is equal to the linear momentum of the center of mass of the system. Now replace PS by 2I, replace PG by 6VG, therefore VG is equal to 1 over 3I, which is equal to 0.33I, expressed in meters per second.
Focus, please. This is important.
Let's move to part 4. After the collision, air rebounds and attains a maximum height HC, which is equal to 0.27 meters, part 4.1. Determine the mechanical energy of the system A, Earth, at point C. The mechanical energy at point C is equal to the kinetic energy at point C plus the gravitational potential energy at point C. During the motion of the object from N to C, the work done by its weight results in a transformation of kinetic energy into gravitational potential energy. So the kinetic energy decreases during the motion between N and C. The kinetic energy becomes zero at the maximum height. Therefore, Ke at point C is equal to zero. The expression of the gravitational potential energy at point C is mAg HC. The mass is 2 kilograms, the gravitational acceleration is 10 meters per second squared, and HC is equal to 0.27 meters. Therefore, the mechanical energy at point C is equal to 5.4 joules. Part 4.2, deduce the speed V2A of the object A right after the collision. We will apply the principle of conservation of mechanical energy. Then the mechanical energy at point C is equal to the mechanical energy right after the collision. The mechanical energy at point C is equal to 5.4 joules. The mechanical energy after the collision is equal to the kinetic energy plus the gravitational potential energy. Look at the figure. The collision takes place on the horizontal track NM, which belongs to the reference level for gravitational potential energy. Therefore, the gravitational potential energy after the collision is equal to zero. Then we still have the kinetic energy after the collision. Its expression is 1/2 mv². The mass is 2 kilograms and the speed is V2A, therefore V2A is equal to 2.32 meters per second.
Part 5. Determine by applying the law of conservation of linear momentum of the system AB, the velocity V2B of B right after the collision. Consider the system AB. We know that the linear momentum of the system just before the collision is equal to that right after the collision. P before is the linear momentum before the collision, and P after is that after the collision. P before is denoted by PS, and the linear momentum of the system after the collision is equal to the linear momentum of A after the collision plus that of B after the collision. Now replace each physical quantity by its value. PS is calculated before is equal to 2i. MA is equal to 2 kilograms, V2A is equal to 3i, and MB is equal to 4 kilograms. Therefore, V2B is equal to 1.66i, expressed in meters per second.
Let's move to part 6. Specify the nature of the collision. We will consider the system AB. We will calculate the kinetic energy of the system just before the collision and right after the collision, and then we will compare their values. Let's start with the kinetic energy before the collision. The kinetic energy before the collision is equal to the sum of the kinetic energies of the two objects before the collision. MA is equal to 2 kilograms. The speed of A before the collision is 3 meters per second. The mass of B is 4 kilograms, and its speed before the collision is equal to 1 meters per second. Therefore, the kinetic energy of the system AB before the collision is 11 joules. Let's move to the kinetic energy after the collision. So it is equal to kinetic energy of A after the collision plus the kinetic energy of B after the collision. The mass of A is 2 kilograms, its speed after the collision is 2.32 meters per second. The mass of B is 4 kilograms, its speed after the collision is 1.66 meters per second. Therefore, the kinetic energy of the system AB after the collision is equal to 11 joules. Compare the kinetic energy before the collision to the kinetic energy after the collision. They are equal. Therefore, this collision is elastic.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.